Hey, Sunny here, and welcome to Sunny DIY. I'm actually in a hotel at the moment because I'm traveling. But if you follow me on Instagram, you know that I've been super into Pokemon Go lately. I mean, who isn't really? So this week, I wanted to make something Pokemon related, and I want to experiment working with felt for the first time. So I made Pokeballs. I mean, they are so cute, and I think the project is easy enough for someone who has never worked with felt before. And along the way, I learned a few tips and tricks from the mistakes I made, and I want to share them with you guys. So let's get to the DIY.
We'll need red, white, and black felt, and the all-important felting needle. These needles are different because they have these little pricks on them, but they are very sharp, so be careful. My plan was to first turn the red color felt into a ball. Felt usually comes in a long strip with strands and is very soft. Here comes the first trick I learned. It will be easier to form a shape you want by roughly folding the felt into the same shape. So to form a ball, I rolled up the felt, tuck in the two sides along the way to make a ball. Then, the stabbing starts. The second trick I learned is that in order to make a ball as round as possible, you want to evenly stab the felt from all angles. The key thing is not to rage quit when it's a little messy at the beginning. The more you stab a location, the less raised it will be. As I was stabbing away, I thought it would probably be a good idea to protect my desk. So I placed a piece of sponge underneath. And then, I thought, logically speaking, if I use three needles at the same time, the process should be three times as fast. But nope, that didn't work. Somehow, it wasn't as effective as using only one needle. After about 10 minutes, I had a ball. We all know that Pokeball is half white and half red. So to turn half of it white, take your white color felt and measure how much you need to cover half of the ball. Place the felt over the ball and start to secure the location by, you guessed it, stabbing. Seriously, I think the minus stabbing is having a therapeutic effect on me. Secure the position of the edge first, followed by the top section, and cut off any excess lengths you don't need. If you think any area is not well covered enough, just add a small piece of felt to it and stab to secure. Don't worry about not getting the edge perfectly straight though, because in the next step, we'll be using black felt to add the black stripe. Again, same process, thin strip, cover, and stab to secure. It's already taking shape. The final detail is the button. Roll a small piece of black felt into a little circle and secure it in place. You can choose a side of the ball that you are most happy with and make that side the front. Then, using an even smaller piece of white color felt, make an even smaller circle and stab to secure. And you have a Pokeball! I had lots of fun throwing around pretending to capture things. But to turn it into a little charm you can carry around, grab a piece of wire that's longer than the diameter of the ball and roll up the end into a little circle. Poke it through the center of the Pokeball from the bottom to the top. And you can use needle here to make a little tunnel first. Then simply roll the wire into a loop at the top. You will of course need a keychain ring, and using a jump ring, connect the two pieces together. And that's it!
Thanks for watching, I hope you'll make it yourself. If you like this video, remember to hit that thumbs up button. If you want to see more DIY videos from me every Thursday, remember to subscribe, and I will see you all next week. Bye!